Annie Perez. She's going to tell us more about that item on how Vice President Sara Duterte is rejecting the very idea of becoming the leader or the new leader of the political opposition. We have her back on the line. Annie, go ahead.
Yes, Carmina, that's right. Vice President Sara Duterte said this over the weekend during her visit to Cebu, and she said that she is shunning the tag that she is the next leader of the opposition. Vice President Duterte was here for Pasidungog 2024 for the annual awarding ceremony of her office to different partners and stakeholders, LGUs and other individuals. Duterte said in an Ambush interview that her focus now is not politics, but in the transition of turning over her position as Secretary of Department of Education. She said that in her work and in her personality, her principle is not to move for the administration or the opposition, but for the betterment of the Filipino people. The vice president also said that she has no intention of joining a national political party at the moment. Her affiliations are only to Hugpong ng Pagbabago in the local level and the Hugpong ng Taong Lungsod based in Davao City. However, she reconfirmed that her brothers and former President Rodrigo Duterte are running for higher position. Both Congressman Punong Duterte and Davao City Mayor Baste Duterte and former President Rodrigo Duterte are eyeing for seats in the Senate. She says that friends and groups of her brothers and the former president also affirmed this. As for her, she says that she has no intention at the moment. Meanwhile, Cebu Governor Gwen Garcia reassured President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. That she has his unwavering support during the recent visit of the president in Cebu. President Marcos Jr. graced the opening of the 36th joint meeting on the United Nations Tourism Commission for East Asia and the Pacific and South Asia last Friday. In her speech, Garcia said that she, along with the other leaders in the province and its people, continue to exhibit unity as did the president called for during the 2022 election campaign. Garcia mentioned the presence of an extraordinary unity that has the impetus of the island province and that this will bring Cebu to great heights of progress and developments. Cebu gave Marcos Jr. over 1.5 million votes in the 2022 elections, which is a far margin of his closest opponent. Governor also said that it was only Marcos Jr. who saw that unity was the only way for the country to move forward. Garcia did not mention Vice President Sara Duterte in the speech, but she did mention some who quote-unquote failed to achieve unity but did not specify any name. She also assured the president that this will not happen in Cebu under her leadership. It could also be recalled that Governor Garcia was a strong supporter for the UNI team during the 2022 presidential elections. And that's the latest from Cebu. Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks a lot, Annie Perez, there joining us on the line. Authorities recover an abandoned vehicle in Tarlac believed to be linked to the recent disappearance of a beauty queen and her Israeli boyfriend. Our very own Gracie Rutao now joins us with that story. Gracie, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, last night around 8 p.m., operatives from the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group uncovered an abandoned vehicle in Sitio Barbon, Barangay Tibag, Tarlac City, Tarlac. The SUV bearing plate number NGN9240 is suspected to be linked to a person of interest identified by authorities in relation to the disappearance of Kapampangan beauty queen Geneva Lopez and her Israeli fiancé, Yitzhak Cohen. The operation was launched following information received from credible sources, resulting in the discovery of abandoned vehicles. This marks the third vehicle reportedly associated with the missing couple and their middleman, who were last seen visiting the property being acquired by the couple in Barangay Armenia, Tarlac City, on the afternoon of June 21. Law enforcement agencies are currently conducting a thorough investigation and interviewing potential witnesses in the vicinity. The recovered abandoned vehicle is scheduled to be handed over to the Highway Patrol Group. That's the latest from Tarlac. Back to you, Carmina.
Thanks a lot. Gracie Rutao there joining us on the line. Minimum wage earners in the National Capital Region getting a pay hike. Labor Secretary Benny Laguesma announced beginning July 17, minimum wage earners in the NCR will receive a 35 peso increase in their daily salary. This raises the daily minimum wage to 645 pesos. North Korea launches two ballistic missiles, the latest in the series of weapons tests by Pyongyang that have soured relations with Seoul. The first short-range ballistic missile was fired to the northeast and flew about 600 kilometers. The second, an unknown ballistic missile, was detected from the same area shortly after. On Sunday, North Korea criticized a joint military exercise by South Korea, Japan, and the United States held last month and warned of an overwhelming response against such drills.